Bonjour, I'm Darcy O'Callaghan from Food and Water Watch based in Washington, D.C. I think we have agreement on a lot of issues in this room, and we've heard many of them here already this morning. So in the spirit of making commitments, my first commitment on behalf of Food and Water Watch is to continue to fight against the financialization of natural resources, specifically at the World Bank and the International Financial Institutions. And the first way we'll work towards doing that is through hosting a specific meeting as a coalition effort at the World Bank spring meetings in April. We invite others of you to join us in that effort. The second thing is that I commit to doing my part towards working towards actually creating the Human Right to Water Summit that we want to see in the fall of 2014. And as soon as we get through our work towards Rio, I say we switch efforts and start developing solid strategies for that. And specifically, we'll need to look at putting in the safeguards towards preventing corporate influence in the UN. Final commitment is that our movement for many years has been holding meetings every Thursday, Skype conference calls. And as David pointed out, we have challenges with language because these calls are in English. But we need to look at ways towards making those calls multilingual or merging our cross-language issues. However, in those calls, we invite all of you to join us on Thursdays and to not only look at advancing the right to water, but also our work fighting financialization of natural resources in the road to Rio. Thanks.
Thank you. Good morning. This is Shayna with Corporate Accountability International, located in the U.S. I'd just like to make a few comments. We need to fight to identify and address the root causes of the commodification of water and the broader social problems that we are facing. We are witness to the capture of governance structures by elite interests and particularly transnational corporations. We need to organize ourselves to systematically expose and challenge this capture, as well as to call for concrete, binding regulations to protect policymaking from corporate interference at the UN and elsewhere. In addition, the World Bank and other IFIs continue to play a key role in legitimating further governance capture by transnational corporations through their promotion of partnership and their increasing investment directly in the private sector. The World Bank Group is playing a particularly crucial role in this regard. And this friendship or partnership model of a relationship with transnational corporations is none other than madness. We need to expose and push the World Bank Group to stop these activities, which are undermining governance generally and democratic governance of water. For this, we're launching a campaign to get the World Bank Group to divest from private water, and we hope that you will join us. Thank you.
Olá, sou Yari, de Brasil, e falo aqui em nome das 400 mil famílias que têm logrado acesso à água potável para consumo humano e para produção de alimentos. E aí dizemos no seminário do Brasil que o outro mundo possível, sonhado em Porto Alegre, já existe e está em curso nas comunidades sustentáveis, que a cada dia logram êxito em suas invenções de novas alternativas. E neste fórum, todo o que mirei, me parece que a crítica que se faz à economia verde, ou azul, ou que color seja, está muito boa. Somos buenos em la crítica, mas me parece que damos pouca visibilidade à construção de alternativas. E me parece que a proposta para seguir um movimento internacional por el agua é que, assim como fazemos a crítica, também possamos dar visibilidade à construção de alternativas. E assim trago a experiência de articulação de semiárido por la captação de água de lluvia, que he visto pouco aqui neste fórum, não sei como os companheiros de Peru, bueno, que esta captação de água de lluvia, talvez a lluvia por ser feminina, é revolucionária, é hermosa, é todo lo de bueno. E como podemos deixar isso, o que é bueno? Temos que captar a lluvia, se no campo, se na cidade, e isso tem que ser com recurso público. Esta é a proposta que o fórum apoie as iniciativas de captação de água de lluvia, mas com recurso público, como política pública, e não apenas com as mãos e os esforços das comunidades. Gracias.
I'm Oswald Quinton from an organic farmers network in South India and a member of EN+ES+FR International. We condemn monopoly of groundwater and demand an urgent introduction of groundwater laws. We condemn monopoly of potable aquifers. They should be under the control of the communities. They must be considered as heritage and protected at all costs.
Va nous lire, c'est assez court, fin d'introduction. Et en fait, pour moi en tout cas, je ne sais pas si c'est certainement plusieurs, c'est un texte qui résume vraiment l'atelier et qui est assez magique pour nous, en tout cas, notre sentiment de rapprochement du nord au sud et de lutte vraiment différente, une vraie convergence. Donc,
buen día. Bueno, gracias a todas las personas del foro y también a la de la sesión de agua y del extractivismo que han trabajado muchísimo. Estoy sorprendido de la cantidad de gente joven con mucho empuje, con mucha capacidad y mucho compromiso. Y, me alegra cómo la vida sigue haciendo surgir jóvenes, la tierra, la Pachamama, los hace brotar a pesar de los que otros acaban la vida, como el compañero de México. Y paso a leer las conclusiones del taller. Los que pertenecemos a diferentes luchas contra el extractivismo, explotación de los bienes naturales, que es la explotación de los bienes naturales a escala industrial, podría ser el nuevo nombre del colonialismo. O sea, pertenecemos a las diferentes luchas contra el extractivismo en todas sus formas: hidrocarburos convencionales, minería, gas y petróleo de esquisto, mega represas, modelo agroindustrial, que somos originarios de muchos países del sur y del norte. Reconocemos que somos todos parte de la misma lucha y que estamos vinculados a todas las luchas por el agua. Denunciamos la criminalización de la protesta social, cuyo último ejemplo es el asesinato del compañero mexicano Bernardo Vázquez Sánchez de México, que luchaba contra las mineras. Hay leyes en muchos países que criminalizan la protesta, no se puede hablar. No solo denunciamos a las multinacionales extractivas, sino también a las instituciones financieras internacionales, los tratados internacionales y los estados que apoyan este modelo. Llamamos a la creación del Tribunal Penal Internacional para que castiguen delitos ambientales, para juzgar los crímenes de lesa humanidad contra los pueblos. Por fin llamamos no solo a luchar contra el extractivismo, sino a cambiar modos de consumo para poner fin al sobreconsumo y al dogma del crecimiento económico que lleva a la exacerbación de la, y a la aceleración de la extracción de los bienes naturales y del agotamiento del planeta. De alguna manera se plantea sí o sí un cambio muy profundo en toda la vida.
¡Bravo!